So you probably heard of the name Genghis Khan or Genghis Khan. But you might not realize that something like 1 in 200 men in the world were genetically related to Genghis Khan. So he was obviously very prolific, yeah, but it makes sense because it's not just him, but it's also his sons and all of his grandsons. They would wipe out enemies that weren't in their lineage. But there's more to this story than you thought. Genghis Khan was first motivated by a girl. According to the secret history of the Mongols, this legend, he was betrothed to a young girl. They didn't talk to each other, but he went through this horrible period where his father had been killed, his horses had been stolen from him and his family, and then he was enslaved. And through all this time, you know, over the years, she waited for him. And one day, he escaped from all of this, and he went out and he found her. As they were riding along, these enemies showed up. She turns to him and she says, "You have to go, you have to run." And he rides off towards this mountain, and he's heartbroken. And he prayed to Tengri, "What should I do, what should I do?" And the moment that he decided he was gonna fight back, global history changed. For that was the very first fight that he ever had, and he got her back. And within a single lifetime, he created the largest contiguous empire in human history from nothing. And it was all a love story. I would say that he was very charismatic.
Scientists thought that chameleons change color by changing the pigment in their skin. Not true. How they actually change color is far more complex.